Andy Amrine, host of the Around Town series on BPTV. Today we're in Judge Arnoni's chambers, and there's a reason we're here. We're doing a special show today in the chambers with not just our own Judge Arnoni, but with two judges. We have our judge. We also have the judge from South Park, Jefferson area, and that's Judge Guy Reschenthaler. And they're putting together a special program on September 24th at Duffel Park High School Auditorium. It's a place you're not going to want to miss. That night, you're going to learn all about the monsters of social media and what's out there, what's affecting our kids, what we need to know about, and what we need to prevent. So sit back, watch this segment. It's going to be an eye-opener for you, and learn all about what's going on September 24th.
I'm Ron Arnoni. I'm the district judge here in Bethel Park and Upper St. Clair.
I'm district judge Guy Reschenthaler. I'm the judge in Pleasant Hills, South Park, and Jefferson Hills.
Gentlemen, tell us what we're doing here today. What do you have to present to us?
Sure. We have a very worthwhile program coming to our community. It's called The Darker Side of Technology, and it's a presentation by cybercrimes expert Jim Dill. And the way we came up with this idea is that I was at a magisterial district judge class, and I got the opportunity to see Jim present this program. And at the end of the program, there were judges that were crying, other judges were speechless. Everybody was really impacted. And I thought that this is something I need to bring to my community. So I reached out to Jim Dill to get him to come to the community. And then I found out that Judge Ron Arnoni was also trying to get the same program together for his community. So we decided that we would join forces, and that makes a lot of sense because our communities are so similar, and it's something that we have both seen on the bench.
Well, what can you tell us about Jim Dill? Who is Jim, and how is he an expert on these subjects?
Jim Dill is a very old dear friend of mine from the Attorney General's office, actually. I worked with him for a lot of years. He was the Chief Deputy Attorney General, and he actually headed the technical division of the Attorney General's office, and he's probably one of the best cyber crimes experts and technology experts in the region. And Jim does these presentations and seminars all across the country, and we're going to be really lucky to have him present. His background is very extensive. He spent well over 25 years with the Attorney General's office and has dealt with all these different types of issues as it relates to technology.
Okay, now we've heard in the news issues about this cyberbullying and sex texting and so forth. Is this really an issue in our communities in Bethel Park, South Park, Upper St. Clair, Jefferson? I mean, I don't see it in the newspapers locally, but does that mean we have it, we don't have it? What can you tell us about our communities?
It's absolutely something that our communities are seeing, and just the statistics of how many of our youth are engaging in sexting, it's absolutely staggering. I can tell you that I've seen it as a prosecutor and defense attorney while in the Navy. I know Judge Arnoni has seen it at the Attorney General's office, and we have both seen it from the bench. In fact, one of my first cases involved a fight that had occurred largely because of cyberbullying, and I've certainly seen cases involving sexting. Judge Arnoni, I'm sure you've seen the same.
Yeah, we've seen numerous cases involving not only sexting, but cyberbullying as well. And it's really an incredibly relevant issue as it relates to our communities today and just the social environment. Because as much as technology has been around for a while, and Facebook and Twitter and what have you, it's becoming even more prevalent in our society, and Judge Reschenthaler and I are trying to get out in front of this issue and be proactive about it so that we can educate and communicate how serious of an issue this is, and the fact that we need to, educate the public and make them aware that this could really get out of hand if we don't get out in front of it.
Now, how about the ages? Is this something that we see from kindergarten up through high school, or is it prevalent just at high school level? What can you tell us about the demographics of this type of crime?
Well, I don't think these series of crimes and cyberbullying, I don't think it has an age limit on it by any stretch of the imagination. We are specifically targeting the middle school students, and some schools are including fifth grade students, some are including ninth grade students, but we're after that demographic just because we think they are likely the most vulnerable, and we want to get out to them and tell them the message before they become victims.
Okay, should we be looking at this happens to more the young ladies, or is it more the boys? Is there a cross between the two genders as far as this?
There is. It's encompassing all the way around gender, all the way around age. We even get into a little bit of predator issues in these segments. We're going to be dealing with examining social networking, how information is being misused, understanding social networking and security, showing different apps and methodology there. Also, risky student behavior and what school districts can do to mitigate and try to take care of those issues. Long-term consequences of sharing and misusing information online. Again, stalking, cyberbullying, sexting, and just learning different ways how to, as I said, mitigate the risks that involve all these types of circumstances.
Now, you've seen Jim's presentation. Is this a multimedia presentation, or are we just, if we come, are we just going to see someone standing on a stage at a podium and talking to us? What could we expect to see from this presentation?
Jim's program is very dynamic. First off, Jim is a very good presenter. He's very knowledgeable and he knows how to captivate the audience, but also he has just a phenomenal PowerPoint that's filled with pertinent videos. He also has, he'll take a smartphone app and show how to address security features on the phone. It's very interactive, very dynamic, and very entertaining.
Okay, what would you tell the parents of the middle school kids that you're targeting? Why should they come to this?
What's great is what Judge Reschenthaler and I are doing is we're bringing this not only to a wide and broad spectrum of school districts throughout our area, but also inviting the public to come on Wednesday, September 24th at 7:30 p.m. In the evening at the Bethel Park Auditorium to also be able to get an idea of how they can arm and educate themselves and see the presentation through their own eyes that their children are going to see that day and the following day, because this is going to be a two-day event that Judge and I are doing. And what I would say to the parents is it's imperative that you're there, that you will learn, you will take away things. I was very surprised at how much and how technologically savvy I thought that I was, and then to learn some of the things that I did and to become more informed is very eye-opening, and I would recommend highly that anyone that's concerned about their kids or that wants to learn a little more about technology, please come out.
Now, Ron, you're talking as a dad now, mm-hmm. instead of a judge, because I know you have children. You're emphasizing this more as a father that a parent needs to be there for it.
Yes, Andy. In fact, you're 100% right. As a father, as a parent, and that's what I bring to the bench too, is that balance. You have to be able to look at all sides, and certainly, yes, it hit home. It hit home.
Okay, so you both learned something from this presentation. And that's what's bringing it forward.
Oh, absolutely.
Okay, now this event is at where is the event at?
It's at Bethel Park High School Auditorium. Okay. It's Wednesday, the 24th of September, and it starts at 7:30.
Okay, now the first one is you're not asking for the kids to come to this then? This one is just for the parents?
No, we're inviting anyone and everyone to that event. Even though we're, the reason why I say that is maybe the parents might say, oh, geez, now I have to leave my kids at home. No, bring your kids. This is, even though we're doing some of these events in the schools, some of the age groups may not be hit because we're primarily handling the middle school. Well, maybe somebody that has a kid in 10th grade or somebody that has a kid in 5th grade might want to bring their kids to this event. I recommend it, I suggest it, and I have no problem with kids coming in. And actually, after we get through with the presentation with Jim Dill, Judge Reschenthaler and I will be available for questions and answers.
Okay. Now, if someone has a younger child, is it okay to bring them also? Someone in third grade or fourth grade and they don't want to get a sitter. Is there information that is going to be too graphic for them or anything to see? Or do you think it's okay to bring the younger kids?
I think it's okay to bring the younger kids. I sat through the presentation and I thought that it was age appropriate.
Okay. And then you said that you are going to be doing another presentation really just geared towards the kids the very next day?
This is part of a two-day whirlwind tour.
Okay.
As we're having it, we're going to go to all our middle schools, Upper St. Clair, Bethel Park, South Park, Pleasant Hills Middle School, which serves as Jefferson Hills and Pleasant Hills. And then we're also having a program for the local Catholic schools in the area. And then this is going to take place, the parental program or the community program is going to take place on the evening between the 2 days. So this is just one talk out of several over a two-day period.
You guys are going to be busy for those couple of days and evening.
We've been busy leading up to it, believe me.
But it's that important to you to spend this much time in putting a program together?
Extremely important. And, you know, when Guy and I came to the bench and we decided we wanted to be proactive and be involved in the community and try and help out any way that we can, we looked at this issue as one that we're going to pinpoint and address in a very aggressive manner. And there's other ones upcoming that we're going to be presenting in the future, but right now we're focused on this and trying to help and educate our constituents, our residents of our communities we represent.
Judge Ron Arnoni and Judge Guy Reschenthaler present The Darker Side of Technology with cyber crimes expert James Deal, Wednesday, September 24th, 7:30 p.m., Bethel Park High School Auditorium. For information on the event, you can go to Ron Arnoni District Justice Facebook page, and you can learn more details about the event. Do you think teachers should be at this event? Is this something that you think teachers can learn something from an assembly like this?
Absolutely. I really think that teachers should make themselves absolutely available to come. They can, I know the judge and I have learned things and they would as well. And I think they would be thankful to come because they're dealing with this stuff even more so than we are, essentially. And we want to stop it before it becomes an issue. So I would highly recommend that the teachers come. They'll find it to be very useful.
When you say stopping it before there's an issue, does that mean like before it comes before you two on the bench? Can you speak on?
Well, exactly. So when it comes before us, it's too late to stop the child from being victimized. It's too late for someone to not send that sext message. But if we can get out there in the community and prevent these problems before they become problems, and make sure it doesn't even come before us, and we're really doing our jobs and we're really making the community safer.
Okay. Now, I've been in this community 54 years. I don't think I've ever seen an event or an activity like this where I have an opportunity to have two judges working on the same game plan. Is this something that I just haven't seen, or is this that unusual?
It's not only that unusual, it's rather unprecedented that you know, Judge Reschenthaler and myself decided to get together and do this because we thought it was best for the communities and essential and something that we, you know, feel very near and dear to our hearts, and some way to help the community and bring about and foster change in the idea of how we look at technology and the social mediums.
Okay. Closing thoughts, once again, what can you, you know, surmise what this is or how important it is to us as residents, whether we have children, gonna have children in the future, you know, what's your closing thoughts on this?
Absolutely, I think what it all comes down to is us being proactive as a community to make a difference. And I think that we have a problem right here that's very timely, it's new, and it's something that affects everybody in the community. And if we can get out there and educate the community and bring awareness, then it's gonna help out the community as a whole and prevent, like I said, problems before they come before the bench.
And something I'd like just to add to that, and certainly I concur with everything the judge has said, is that we as a community need to band together and get out in front of these kind of issues. And like I tell some kids that have been in my courtroom in the past or people that I've dealt with regard to posting things and getting on the internet, if it's something you don't want your grandmother to see on the billboard driving down the road, don't send it. You know, that and that's just one small example of a lot of the things that you're going to see, even things with regard to your smartphones that you might not be aware of that you're going to find out at this event. And that's just a little teaser of some of the many things that you're going to learn should you be wise enough to come and check this presentation out.
Okay, now, I'm assuming we probably have a few people or corporations or sponsors to thank for, you know, getting Jim Dill here and putting this event, this multi-day event together. Is there anyone special you'd like to send a thank you out to?
Yes, and let me just preface by saying, you know, Jim Dill has been a great partner in this, and he's the one who's really gone out and taken the leadership role in getting these sponsors. Judge Reschenthaler and I had you know, made some suggestions, but Jim's really the one that's been on the forefront of taking care of any kind of sponsorships and things of that nature. And I'm going to mention a few of the sponsors that Jim's been able to attain and we've been able to work with, and Judge Reschenthaler will do the same. First of all, the Bethel Park Recreation, who has really partnered in this and made it part of their speaker series. The law offices of Joe Cavelli, law offices of Hancheck and Pratt, and the law offices of Scott Lautner, the West Jefferson Hills Chamber of Commerce, Pleasant Hills Rotary, St. Louis, DeMarillac, St. Thomas More, the school districts of Bethel Park, South Park, Upper St. Clair, and West Jefferson Hills, the chiropractic firm Dr. James Weiner and chiropractic Dr. Guy Reschenthaler, and of course my partner, Judge Guy Reschenthaler.
Thanks, Judge.
Okay.
And in addition to that, we have Miser, Print Management, Shop and Save, and Health Tracks.
Okay, wonderful. How about once again, give us the date, time, and location?
Absolutely. It's Wednesday, September 24th, 7:30 p.m., Bethel Park High School Auditorium.
All right, we'll see you then, gentlemen.
Be there.
Thank you. Judge Ron Arnoni and Judge Guy Reschenthaler present The Darker Side of Technology with cyber crimes expert James Deal, Wednesday, September 24th, 7:30 p.m., Bethel Park High School Auditorium. For information on the event, you can go to Ron Arnoni District Justice Facebook page, and you can learn more details about the event. Thank you for watching another segment of Around Town. I'm Andy Amrine, host of the series on BPTV. Once again, I hope to see you Wednesday night, September 24th at the Bethel Park High School Auditorium to see this fabulous program. I think it's a must-see for everybody.